Let's investigate light bulb efficiency using the code node. So what type of light bulbs do you have in your home? Have you ever considered that you have some types that are much more energy efficient than others? How can you test the efficiency of LED and older incandescent light bulbs? You can do just this by measuring the thermal energy that radiates off the bulb. For this activity, you'll need a code node, an incandescent bulb, and an LED, and a ring stand with a holder. If you don't have the ring stand, you can use a tape measurer and just hold the code node approximately 15 centimeters above the bulbs. You can use various wattage levels of light bulbs, but make sure they're equivalent. For example, today I'm using a 14-watt LED bulb and a 100-watt incandescent light bulb. Now, the incandescent light bulbs get extremely hot to the touch, so make sure you're using lamp clamps to avoid having to change the bulbs and risking a burn. So let's get started. First, I'm going to turn on the code node, and I'm going to select sensor data in my SparkView software. And you'll see that my device is paired. For this demonstration, we're going to be measuring the heat that's radiating off of the bulb. So I'm going to choose the temperature sensor here to get ambient temperature. And then I'm going to click on the graph display. You should have temperature over time, which we do. And I'm going to start with the LED bulb. I'll turn that on. And then there's one other thing I want to do before I get started. Down here, you see where it's set at 20 hertz for my sampling. I want that to be 1 hertz, so I get a data point for every second. All right, temperature over time, LED bulb on. And let's start. We're going to run this for 4 minutes, and we're going to go ahead and speed up the data for you. And I expanded my graph so my data is clearer to read. Okay, I'm gonna stop recording my data. Move the code node over to the incandescent bulb. And then I'm gonna click start, and we're gonna record for another 4 minutes, and again, we'll speed it up for you. All right, we've hit the 4-point mark and we've stopped collecting data. Okay, now that we collected our data, I've pulled up run one first, and this was our LED bulb. Run two was using our incandescent bulb. And remember, we were measuring thermal output here, so it's pretty evident that the incandescent bulb is giving off much more heat than the LED, which is equating to a lower efficiency because we're losing light to heat. All right. Now, the reason we did this is it's going to help me with a data point that I'm going to use in a Blockly code program we're going to do right now. Now that we've seen how the code node can be used to collect data, let's now create a Blockly coding program that will identify higher and lower efficiency light bulbs. We can use the data we collected to help us with our code creation. So I'm looking at run one and run two, and I can see here that the light bulb, the incandescent light bulb, increased in temperature pretty steadily, getting up to about 26 degrees Celsius. So I know, because of the amount of thermal output coming off this incandescent bulb, it's a lower efficiency. So that's important. To create the code, I'm going to click on the code icon, and let's build our program. Start with a loop, while true. I need to put in my conditionals, my statements. All right, I'm gonna pull the hardware out. This is temperature. If you ever need to adjust, you can just click here, but we focused on temperature, so I'm going to leave that. Pull in a math block for my temperature reading. We're going to set this up. If it gets above a certain temperature, it is going to make a sound. So I'm going to pull my speaker in here, set that at about 500 hertz. I'm going to duplicate that block because if it doesn't hit that certain temperature, it's not going to do anything at all. And I'm going to create some text output. So to do that, I clicked code output, create text. I'm just going to give this a name that makes it easy for me to reference later. So I'm just doing light bulb efficiency abbreviated. And now I can pull this out. So if it goes over a certain temperature, I know that's going to indicate a lower efficiency light bulb. And duplicate again. Because if it doesn't get too warm, it's going to be a higher efficiency bulb. All right, so let's make sure our code's set. I've got my loop while true. So this is where the temperature comes into play. Remember, we looked at the data before. It got up to about 20 degrees Celsius. It took a little bit of time to get there. So for the sake of this demonstration, I'm going to set the temperature lower. I can see what it's reading right now. It says 25.4. So let's set this at 25.7. All right, I'm going to turn on my incandescent light bulb. That's the only one you would really need for this demonstration. And let's see if it works. I forgot one thing. If you want to see the text output, you have to add an additional page, and I'm going to do that right now. So I'm going to pick the two-page layout. I want the temperature to be visual. And then to get to that text output you created, you go into user entered, and I gave it a name to easily reference, and I'm good to go. All right, so let's start this again. So far, so good. I'm reading higher efficiency because I'm below that threshold. There I go. I hit the number I needed to. My speaker is going off and I'm getting a text output of lower efficiency. So that's one demonstration that you can do using the code node. Thank you.